At the outset, I would like to thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity to share my views on this public sector summit. I am TV Reddy, Chief Vigilance Officer. I belong to Indian Forest Service of 1987 batch, Assam cadre. I am on deputation as CEO to Nidani. I am working as CEO for the last 1.5 years. So I am not a part of an insider of Nidani, but as a Chief Vigilance Officer on deputation, I would like to give you a few of details regarding the PSU Nidani. Nidani, many of the people may not be knowing because it is a small organization, Mishra Dhatu Nigam, Defense PSU, involved in the manufacturing of super alloys, which are used in the strategic sectors. This organization was the offshoot of the DRDO, Defense Metallurgical Research Laboratory, which is located in Hyderabad. It is more of a, not as a commercial enterprise, but as a unit established to make India self-reliant in the strategic sectors, especially in the materials, super alloys, which we were importing, and to develop indigenous capability. This unit was established as a small unit within the DRDO premises, the DMR at Kanchanbar. So as a small unit in the year 1973, it has started. The technology which has been developed by the DMRL to start some commercial production, they have established this as a unit under Defense Ministry. So in the year 1973, it was established, and only in the year 1981 and 82, it could develop, it could turn around of about 3.2 crores super alloys, which were used for defense sector. So as the journey, now 2003 and 4 had a slow growth. It made a turnover. For the first time in the 2003 and 4, the performance of the PSU excellent. It was recorded in the 13th year of signing the Memorandum of Understanding with Ministry of Defense. And a maiden dividend of 137 lakhs was paid to the Government of India in the financial year 2004. And in the late, now in the, for the last, continuously for the last decade, the growth was good, and it was recognized as a Mini Ratna category in the year 2008. And SCOPE has given this best PSU performance in the mining sector in the year 2009-10 to Nidani. So in the last few years, for the last 6-7 years, the growth has been very good under the leadership of the CMD, the modernization and augmentation of the infrastructure also is taking place. See, basically I would like to give the profile, the major products, the alloys. First one is the barraging steels, which are used in the our missiles and also space. Titanium alloys, which are used again in the ISRO, atomic energy, nuclear power stations. Similar super alloys, we are using in the aeronautical sector and also ordnance factories, which they require special managing skills. These are the categories which Nidani has developed indigenous capability. The super alloys, they can be categorized into nickel based, cobalt based, iron based, and titanium alloys, which are used in the especially the space, aeronautic sector, and also the atomic energy. Nidani is the only one which has got that capacity, indigenous capacity. So to develop this indigenous capacity, the upgradation is taking place, and the major customers are BDL, we have ISRO, and then Ordnance Factory, Navy, shipyards, power sector, DHEL, where this special grade materials are required in their manufacturing. If you see the performance of the PSU, for the last 7 years, up to 2003 and 4, the growth was very slow, not much, but from the 2006 to the present 2013-14, the growth has been spectacular. Every year, the turnover 20% growth is there, even in terms of profit. This year, the turnover was around 590-560 crores, and the profit also around 100 crores. So every year, the PSU is getting excellence in terms of its performance. So as a part of the vigilance, we generally, what our job is to see that the procedures, CVC guidelines are followed in the procurement. Major procurements of the raw materials for the Bidani are imported materials. So very limited kind of sources are there. So in this, the e-procurement, which the CBC was also insisting, so imported materials, in that this exemption has been given. So whatever that procurements which we are procuring from the domestic sources, there the e-procurement has been made compulsory. And as a vigilance department, we only, what we do is we pursue this, the initiatives in the e-procurement, and we do monitor monthly wise and quarterly wise. So during the last 1 year, there has been the e-procurement from the domestic sources, whatever the exempted category of excluding, the e-procurement in the last 1 year, there has been a substantial improvement. It is now reaching up to 80%. Earlier it was hardly 10 or 20% was taking place. So the initiative of IT as the e-procurement, it has given better results in terms of time cycle in the procurement, and also efficiency, and also cost reduction also has taken place. So the management is also very positive, and they are also taking the necessary whatever initiatives are required for this, further improving this e-procurement. Similarly, the transparency in terms of other things like in the HR, in the recruitment process also, all the recruitments, application forms, they are put on the website, and all the application filling is online, so which gives a better transparency in the recruitment. This is one aspect which can reduce corruption, risk of corruption in the recruitment. That is one issue which we are also, we monitor regularly in the, as a part of business activity. Next, as a Bidani, the last 5 years, which is making profits, now as a corporate social responsibility also, they are doing their contribution to the in the community development, especially in the field of education, in the field of health, they are spent under corporate social responsibility. They have taken up schemes to give aids to the physically handicapped persons, and also some of the schools have been adopted, planting programs have been taken up, especially in the campus also, in the Medan campus, the plantation program and the environment improvement program, lake conservation, because a lot of open spaces are there. There, the lake conservation programs. So contributing to the environment also, as a Medani is doing a great deal. These are some of the figures which the value of items which have been supplied to the different statistic sectors. You can see more the 80% of the our customers are basically our government departments or public sector, government public sectors. Only hardly 20% our customers are private. Mainly L&T and certain kind of infrastructure corporation. Now, that's what I said in the earlier, the Medani is now on the, earlier it was a slow growth, now it is on the expansion of the augmentation of the infrastructure. So the expansion is taking place, especially in the modernization and also augmentation of new facilities. The one of the 10-ton force press is coming up, which will be operational this year. And last year, this in-rolling mill, a new facility has been developed. So in the coming years, the Medani will be turning into a 1,000 crore turnover PSU. So in the coming years, we are expecting that it will be declared as a Schedule A company. So these are the things which I wanted to say, because as a vigilance, what vigilance officer we are doing. The earlier my speaker, my Srivastava, what he has said, e-procurement and intervention of the leveraging of technologies. We are trying to improve the further, and in the coming years, we want to see that in the organization to develop as an excellence PSU. In the field of this super alloys, which is the only company in the country which is helps in the self-reliance in the strategic sector.